Hello and welcome to this session in which we'll discuss stock appreciation rights. Stock appreciation rights are a form of compensation, equity compensation, just like stock options and stock rights. They're more preferable than stock options. So to appreciate, no pun intended, stock appreciation right is to compare them to why they are more preferable than stock options. What are stock options? Stock options is when the company gives you the right to buy the stock, for example, at $10. Then let's assume the stock goes up to 15. And let's assume you have 10,000 shares of 10,000 options. What do you have to do? Well, you have to buy the shares. You have to buy the shares. So you have to come up with, if you have to buy the shares at $10 and you have to exercise all your options, not you have to, if you decided to, you have to pay $100,000 upfront to be able to buy the shares. Then you can sell them at 15. And that's really not a major issue because although you may not have the money, you may not have the 100,000, you can borrow it from your broker and immediately buy the shares, then sell them. But the real problem with stock options are the tax consequences. What does that mean? Let's assume the stock options are non-qualified options, and we're not going to go into this topic a little bit more. If you want to learn about the tax consequences, go to farhatlectures.com. But simply put, if you happen to buy the stocks at 10 and the current price is 15, you still have to pay taxes. Although you don't want to sell them, you just want to keep them because you think the stock is going to rise to 20, 25, you still have to pay taxes. So simply put, paying taxes might create a hardship because you have no you don't have the ability to pay. Nevertheless, the options are taxable. So the difference between 10 and 15, you made basically $50,000 and you have to pay taxes on it. So how is stock appreciation different? Well, stock appreciation is you don't have to pay taxes unless you exercise. So the compensation received equal to what we call the share appreciation. Now, how do we measure the share appreciation? So if you don't get the shares, you don't have to pay taxes. But what is the share appreciation? Well, the share appreciation is the excess market price of the stock at the date of the exercise over a predetermined established price. So the way stock appreciation works is something like this. Let's assume the company granted you 100,000 SARs, stock appreciation rights, rather than stock options. And the pre-established price is $10. So this is this part that we said we have to have a pre-established price. Then when you exercise, let's assume the price is at 15 now and you exercise, well, the difference between 15 and 10 is $5. $5 times 100,000 SARs, you have a compensation of $500,000. However, you receive those stocks. So you receive the stocks or the cash. So simply put, you don't have to pay any money up front. And when you receive the cash, you have the ability to pay. Now the stock appreciation right, they can pay you in cash or they can pay you in equity. So we have what's called share-based liability or just shares liability, which is an equity compensation. So stock appreciation can be classified as equity, where you would receive the shares. So rather than giving you $500,000 in cash, they can give you $500,000 worth of stocks, or they can give you $500,000 in cash, which is called the share liability. Now, let's kind of illustrate the difference a little bit more between share-based compensation, which is the equity part, and share-based liability, which is the cash. Well, under share-based compensation, the employee, the executive, receives shares of stocks rather than cash. That's how they compensate you. How does the company record the expense? Well, the expense is considered as the fair value of the SARs. So we would assign a fair value like options, and we allocate this fair value over the service period of that executive's service period. So you need to be familiar with options. For share-based liability, the employee would receive actually cash. Here, the expense will be accrued, basically an accrued expense over the service period. But what's going to happen over the service period, we're going to have to remeasure the fair value each period until the award is settled. Why? Here's what's going to happen. The pre-established stock price is $10. Now, in year one, at the end of year one, the stock goes up to 15. You have $5 profit per SARS. Then the stock might go up in year two to 18. Now you have an additional $3. Then the stock might drop to 11. Now we have to go from 18 to 11. So you lost $7. So we keep on adjusting the SARs. So adjust the cost of the changes and the prorated for the portion of the service period completed. So we have to keep adjusting those compensation. Don't worry, we're going to work an example. Once the service period completed, determine the compensation expense each subsequent period by reporting the full change in the market price as an adjustment to compensation expense. So once you have earned those SARs, you may not exercise them. In other words, you may not ask the company to give you the money. You may keep them for several years because that could be an option for you. So if you keep them for several years and the SARs went from 11 to 13, the company will have to make the adjustment. Or if they go from 13 to 12, they'll have to make another adjustment again. So the expense will change as the fair market value changes. Don't worry, we're going to work an example to illustrate this concept. The good thing is about SARs is the changes are done prospectively. Prospectively means you don't have to go back and change the expense from prior period. You just have to change the expense going forward. The best way to illustrate this concept is actually to work an example, which we will. But before we work an example, I would like to remind you, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I provide you resources to help you with your CPA exam and your accounting courses. I don't replace your CPA review course nor your accounting courses. My motto is saving CPA candidate and accounting students one at a time. How? By providing resources to help you in your accounting courses and your CPA preparation. This is a partial list of my accounting courses. My CPA supplemental material is aligned with your Becker, Roger, Wiley, and Gleam, so it's very easy to go back and forth between my material and your CPA review course. I give you access to 1,500 MCQs previously released. Those are released by the AICPA, so they actually appeared on the CPA exam. That's an addition to thousands of CPA questions and practice questions. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so and take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendations. Like this recording, it helps me a lot. Connect with me on Instagram. I'm trying to grow my Instagram following, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So the best way to illustrate stock appreciation, right, is to actually look at an example. Farhat Lectures started a stock appreciation right plan on January 1st, 20X1. The plan entitled executives to receive cash, so it's a liability based, at the date of the exercise for the difference between the market price and the pre-established price of $20. And we are granting the executives 100,000 SARs. So the value of the SARs at December 31st X1 is $4. Simply put, it means the stock price rose to 24. Now the difference between 20 and 24 is $4. And the service period for those executives are 2 years. So they have to work X1 and X2 with us. So how do we start to compute the expense and how do we record the expense? Well, we're going to prepare this table. For year one, the fair value is 24, so there's an additional $4. The cumulative compensation expense is 400,000. Why? The stock price went up $4. We have 100,000 SARs, so our cumulative compensating expense is 400,000. Now, this 400,000 will have to be spread over 2 years because the executives will have to work for us 2 years. So we're going to be using the percentage, something called the percentage method. So we're going to split this over 50%. And for year one, the cumulative expense accrued to date is only 200,000. Therefore, the expense that we will record for year one is 200,000, which is half of 400,000. We debit compensation expense, 200,000, credit a liability under stock appreciation plan of 200,000. Year two, so this is X1. In year two, the fair value is $7. Simply put, the stock price went to 27. Now, the cumulative compensating expense recognized is 700,000. Why? Because the difference between 20 and 27 is $7, and we have 100,000 SARs. Now, remember, in the prior year, okay, in the prior year, $7 times 100,000 is 700,000. In the prior year, we recognized 200,000 of the 700,000. Therefore, in year two, we only have to recognize 500,000. Therefore, in year two, we recognize expenses of only 500,000. So notice the total $700,000, $200,000 was already recorded in year one. Therefore, the total expense recognized in year two is $500,000. Therefore, this is the entry that we will make in year two. Now, the executive, they were greedy. They did not exercise. They did not want to cash out. In year three, the fair value of the stock went down to 25. So it was 27. Now the fair value of the stock appreciation right is $5 above the predetermined established price of 20. Now the cumulative compensating expense, notice what we do is we keep on adjusting that, is $500,000. And by the way, by year two, it's 100% because the executive completed the period of 2 years. In year three, the period has been, the service period has been met. Therefore, everything is 100%. In year three, the compensating, cumulative compensating expense should be $500,000, not $700,000. Therefore, we have to reduce our expense by $200,000. The executive should have exercised by the end of year two, but they did not. They waited. They thought, you know, they've been greedy. The stock price went down. So in year two, we have to reverse $200,000. We have negative expense. We have to credit expense. And that's not normal, but it could happen. If you follow my financial accounting courses, I always say we never credit expense to make it easy for introductory accounting student, but we do credit expense sometime. And this is an example of it. Therefore, we reduce expenses and we reduce our liability by $200,000 because the stock price went down and we still have that liability to settle. Now we have to keep in mind that we have a liability under SARS, of $700,000. Now we reduced it $200,000. What's left is $500,000. And let's assume now the executive gave up and wants to cash out. Therefore, they want to settle the liability. That means they want to cash out. We're going to debit the liability, $500,000, because that's it. They don't want to wait anymore. They want their money. And we're going to credit cash, $500,000. And this is what happened in year three. So notice this happened in year three and this happened in year three because the executive decided to just settled. Now, usually there's a limit in time. Maybe they have 5 years to settle, but they decided to settle. So in case we have X4, we have to determine what happened after $5. Did it go down to $3? Did it go up to $9? You know, we have to make certain adjustments. The point is it's a cumulative and you have to keep track of it. Now, the best way to learn about SARS and other topics is to go to my website, farhatlectures.com, and work additional MCQs, additional practice questions, look at additional resources. Farhat Lectures is your resources for your accounting courses as well as your CPA exam. Don't shortchange yourself. Your accounting career is important. Your accounting courses are important. Have a strong background so you will succeed on the exam. This way you can focus on your career, move on, and have a good life. It's worth it. Invest. Good luck, study hard, and of course, stay safe.